I am here with Mr. Nsema Ikere, former deputy governor, one of the political leaders in the state. He also ran for the governorship on PDP platform, but he was shut out because the tactics that Akpabio later used during the general elections, there was a prelude. He had used it successfully, even for the PDP primaries, by ensuring that for the delegates' election, he sat in government house and wrote down the names of all the delegates, so they did not have the elections. The names were all written out. And for the main primaries, again, he just sat down and wrote the name of Udom Emmanuel, who was pronounced winner and candidate of the PDP. It was a sham. They did not have primaries. And if you had been following the Akpabio story, of course you know they later had a group because there were 23 aspirants. So all the other 22 aspirants came together under what they called G22. He was the chairman, I'm sure you are still the chairman.
Yes, absolutely the chairman.
Of G22. And that group of very patriotic leaders in Akpabio,
the governorship candidate of APC, were all in PDP together. But by the time you are members of an organization and you see that that organization is deviating from the norms, doing things wrongly, what do? You sit down there and drown with it?
Where Akpabio was boasting.
Oh, he's here.
That he has to win first by all means. This was about his 2011 election. He was addressing a group. And he said, I know the Nigerian system. I know the judiciary. So if I have to kill to win, do whatever I have to do to win, I will do that and win. And then I will sit as governor. Let the other party go to court. He then also said, I know the judiciary. The case would be playing around for 4 years. And by time they're through with the tribunal, to the appeal court, to the Supreme Court, I would have finished my time. And people just laughed. They thought it was very funny. And they laughed and clapped. But that is the mindset. Based on card reader data, the accreditation figure that we have is 437,128. But the purported votes cast or allocated, purported votes allocated, is about almost 1.2 million, 1.1 million. Yes. And Udom Emmanuel, who was declared the winner of the elections, Udom Emmanuel alone was given 996,000 votes, 996,000, against 400 and something thousand, 437,000. 128. In other words, more than double. So this excess votes in excess of accreditation, because the only way you can prove that you had accreditation is to depend on the card reader. So this excess votes of over 100%, where did the votes come from? We call for inspection of materials and forensic evaluation. They frustrated it. The PDP people in connivance with INEC, but the revelations have been most revealing. What we have discovered, sudden revelations. You go there, you find booklets already thumbprinted, clearly thumbprinted by one person. A whole booklet of ballot papers thumbprinted by one person from the beginning to the end. But after doing that, the person is so tired. And because the impunity is so present, he's so tired that he just dumps the booklet. Without even bothering to tear. He just dumps the booklet. We've discovered so many, many cases.
Everywhere.
So many. Collation was not taking place in any of the ward-designated centers, apart from two local governments. No collation was taking place anywhere. We moved to the local government collation centers. Nothing was happening. No activity. And finally, we ended up in Uyo, the state capital, and asked to see the resident electoral commissioner. This we also have. We have a video recording. I'm sure you've seen it. We went there. They barred us. We were not allowed to enter the office, even though the rec was there. He refused to see us. They sent the head of ICT, one gentleman, who came to see us. And we put it to him that we have gone around the whole state. Collation is not taking place anywhere, as is expected. I mean, if you were in Lagos and you voted, you could see that the whole day of the elections, you find people gathering at the ward centers to monitor the collation. Yes, after that, they will follow the results to local governments to monitor the collation. It didn't happen in Akwa Ibom. It did not. Rather, they were busy thumbprinting. They were busy thumbprinting in the houses of people. They were busy thumbprinting. So in the end, when we challenged him and said, that's done it, David. When we challenged him and said, come and show us one collation center just around Uyo anywhere. Of course, he couldn't. He couldn't, because this was happening in the houses of commissioners. So the question we put to them that day was, you are now waiting so that tomorrow you will announce the results of the governorship election. Where will the results come from? Where? If there's no coalition at the world level, there's no coalition at local government level, and you stay here so that tomorrow you'll announce somebody as winner of the elections, the results will come from where? Nobody answered the question. Nobody.
We are telling you, first of all, because of course there was no election, so there would be no result sheets to sign. But now, and I'm telling you what INEC has done. In one of the local government areas, they actually brought result sheets collated from, supposedly, from 10 wards. Now, one person is signing as the INEC staff that conducted this election in the 10 wards. Is it possible that one returning officer
would have been present,
return for 10 wards?
Even the reply by INEC to our petition, they've not been able to attach the polling unit results.
Yes, they haven't.
Till now, we wrote to ask for the polling unit results. They're still not available.
They don't have.
Because they're still battling to see how they can disaggregate.
Break it down.
Break it down.
Units. So, are you saying here that INEC is in connivance with this?
Absolutely.
How could these things happen without INEC?
INEC is the
supervisor. Because we're given 14 days. The first 10 days, we're only able to do 3 local governments because our team will arrive. They can't find the INEC people. Sometimes they will arrive by 6 p.m. And when they arrive, they will tell you, oh, it is the wrong electoral officer. The documents they have is for a particular local government. That electoral officer cannot be located. So that day is gone. And then they had a particular former commissioner, former attorney general, Woko is his name, who would come and issue instructions as if he works in INEC. So we're totally frustrated.
Yeah,
tomorrow,
from the field,
tomorrow we're going back to the tribunal with a new motion for extension of time, because we couldn't do much within the 14 days. And of course, to inform the tribunal about the experiences we had when we were given the first 14 days. So we believe that Nigerians ought to know what is going on, that even the court order is not being complied with.
Being flouted by INEC.
By INEC with impunity. So you talk about rivers, but I can tell you it was worse in Akwa Ibom. Because the template used in Rivers, the author of that template
manufactured in Akwa Ibom.
Made in Akwa Ibom. That template was made in Akwa Ibom. So you don't expect that. you don't expect that they're going to use a template manufactured in Akwa Ibom in Rivers, and then the case of Rivers will be worse than Akwa Ibom. No, because the author is Godswill Akpabio. It was his template. Now, we had issues about even how we could be heard outside Akwa Ibom. Serious issues. On the day of the election, channel did not report the fact that people were killed and we didn't have elections. AIT did not report. ATA did not report. Why? Because totally.
No, channels
because of their man on ground. His name is Moffat. Moffat. Even after the presidential elections, and we now called a press conference to inform Nigerians that, look, this is what happened. We all went to vote. We couldn't find result sheets. The results had been filled already.